All right, well, it's that time of year when Australia's collective GST piggy bank is cracked open and governments find out how many coins they're raking in. But millions of Aussies reckon they're getting dutted.
This entire process is absurd.
It's a feeling you've probably had when the tax man doesn't deliver the return you were hoping for.
That an absurd system like this cannot last, and it's in the interest of the entire Federation that we have reform.
Well, that's how a couple of Aussie states woke up feeling this morning. In Australia, revenue earned from the goods and services tax in each state and territory is paid to the federal government. That money is then redistributed back to the states, with an independent commission deciding every year how much each state will get.
The Grants Commission comes up and says, right, how much does every state really need to give them, their people, the right services, the right goods? And you end up with big variations.
Around a quarter of the money the states make comes from GST, so it's kind of a big deal.
The way it's carved up can mean the difference between getting extra police officers, getting a proper health system, or getting a budget surplus.
Today, the split for the year ahead has been announced, and while most states have been left better off, two are losing out big time, largely due to increased coal mining royalties. New South Wales will receive a $310 million cut to its GST share.
Rather than getting 92 cents in the dollar, it's dropped all the way down to 86.7 cents in the dollar.
Queensland is an even bigger loser, down almost $470 million. Instead of getting $1.03 for every dollar generated, it now gets just 95 cents.
And now New South Wales and Queensland's experiencing very much what the state of WA has been experiencing because of our mining royalty revenue. We've suffered through these cuts year in, year out.
WA, the big winner, will rake in an extra $838 million thanks to a sweet, sweet deal from the Turnbull government era. It stipulates that WA is guaranteed to receive at least 75% of the GST paid in their state, that floor up from 70% last year.
Without that floor arrangement, we'll be getting 11% of the population share of GST in the state. It would be simply not fair, not sustainable.
It's a deal still backed by Labor today, and while it seems no government wants to be the one to upset the West Aussies, is it an arrangement we can still afford?
As Western Australia has got richer on the back of the mining boom, it's become much more politically important. Neither party can afford politically to withdraw from it, because to lose those 16 seats in Western Australia means losing government.
Daniel Mookey is the Treasurer of New South Wales and he's gearing up to fight this decision. Daniel, you say the system is absurd. Why?
Simply put, New South Wales taxpayers are now having to fund all the activities that are taking place in a lot of the other states. We are now giving 14 cents out of every dollar paid in GST by a New South Welsh person is going to other states. A lot of these states should simply be saying thank you to the taxpayers of New South Wales for our generous contribution, but the truth is it's coming at the expense of our ability to provide people with services to the standard that they expect and deserve.
As one of the biggest states, isn't it fair for New South Wales to support some of the states that need it?
Indeed, and we've been doing that ever since the Federation, but we are watching other states benefit tremendously from various mining booms at the same time we are rebuilding our finances here in New South Wales, because we did take on the brunt of the impact of COVID. It's only fair that New South Wales isn't continued to see as the cash cow of the Commonwealth, where every time any other state needs a bailout, it comes at our expense.
Hang on, you're paying what, 86, you're getting 86 cents for every dollar of GST that's spent in your state. So you're upset about that shortfall. WA, who I think you've just referenced there, talk about a mining boom, they're getting 75. So if they want to apply your argument, they should be more upset than you, shouldn't they?
No, they are getting... And look, I congratulate my good friends in WA as they are sipping champagne at Cottesloe Beach celebrating their outcome. They should be saying thank you to the taxpayers of New South Wales, because if it wasn't for that particular arrangement, they'd be getting less. Now, I don't quibble with the fact that other states are going to fight hard for their interests.
They would have been getting less, but they're still getting less per dollar of GST that gets raised in their state than you are. So if your argument is you should be getting all your money,
really
they
simply
could argue exactly the same thing, couldn't they? And then they'd have a stronger argument than you.
I'd simply make this point. They'll get $6 billion more next year than they got last year.
That's not
and
the
we
question.
Will get $1.65
the question is whether or not they're
less.
Getting their money back. And they're getting less of their money back than you are. So if that's the basis of your argument, they should be more upset.
No, I'd make this point. They are celebrating for the very fact that if it wasn't for that special arrangement, they'd be getting 12 cents back. And I say to them, look, good luck to them. I'm not going to begrudge other states for fighting as hard for their interests, but therefore no one should be begrudging my right and our right as New South Wales people to be at the table demanding that we get our fair share too. And it's not just GST. We're seeing the same thing happen in infrastructure, and we want our all the other states and the Commonwealth to make sure that we are all delivering public schools to the standard all our citizens expect as well.
Sure. So the argument about funding education, whatever, we can have those arguments, but what would you like? Would you like WA to be getting 11, 12 cents back from their dollars?
No, I expect the Commonwealth now to be taking seriously the fact that we all have an obligation to ensure that a person turning up to an emergency department in New South Wales has access to a first-class system. I don't expect miracles from the Commonwealth, but I expect good dialogue. I expect us to be able to sit at the table now that this decision has been made and say, how do we ensure that New South Wales doesn't miss out on infrastructure, that we get the money we need for our schools and hospitals, and we get money to help deal with this epic housing crisis for which we are at the epicentre?
Daniel, I want to get real for a second. Let's cut through the red tape. All this infighting between the states is making me uncomfortable. I have a solution. You're going to love this, let me tell you. How about we get rid of all the states? No more states, except one state, New South Wales, right? Then New South Wales gets all the money.
What?
Well, I simply make the point, when the entire continent was ruled from New South Wales, it was a glorious time for many of us. And, of course, if such a responsibility was to fall on us again, we're ready to serve.
I'm in. Let's do it.
Treasurer, it's time to secede, I reckon.
Absolutely.
Yeah, from the rest of Australia.
Yeah, I'm in. I want to see my New South Wales passport. Let's go.
Yeah. Well, look, there's no bad ideas in brainstorming, is what I like to say.
OK, Daniel, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks a lot for having me on.